Hello and welcome to the third episode of Developer, the show where we explain to you the features of Controlix automation with a focus on software solutions, and we will show you how it works. I'm Christian. You may hear it, my voice has not much improved since the last show, but if you want to become a game changer, you have to be a tough guy sometimes. I promised you I will have in each show an expert with me, and today I have here Johannes, yes, which is a real super nerd in our company. He works in our software development department and was significantly involved in the development of Controlix automation. So he can explain almost everything on the new platform, except maybe good old PLC programming, which is not your favorite topic, I know that. But anyway, today we won't talk about that. We will talk about the mysterious Controlix data layer and what it is all about. So okay, welcome here and thanks for being with us.
Hi, Christian. Thanks for the invitation. I guess we see each other more often now.
That's true. You're the only person who joins me not only for one show, but for several ones. So you must be an expert on a lot of topics, and calling you a super nerd is not so wrong, right?
Yeah. Because as a software developer, or you called me a super nerd, I'm really deep involved in developing the software which runs on the Controlix core. And but I'm not the only one who developed the software. I'm representing my colleagues here because we are a big team.
Okay. The Controlix data layer is the big advantage of our new platform. So can you explain to us the role and what makes it so special?
To compare the Controlix core with the human body, the heart of our platform is the Controlix core, and the Controlix data layer is kind of a neural system which connects each organ with each other. And in our case, the Controlix data layer connects the apps with each other because we have an app-based platform here.
In the last episode, we talked about this already. If you missed this show, we put the link below in the comment section. During the last episode, we also learned that Controlix core is based on Linux.
Yes, that's right. With Controlix automation, we rely on Ubuntu core. As you might already know, it's the most used Linux distribution.
Okay, but this is quite revolutionary in the field of automation and machine control, right?
Yes, that's quite revolutionary because we do not longer have a proprietary system. Instead, we use Linux and especially an app-based system.
I like that. I've been working now for maybe 2 decades on proprietary systems, so what you just said is music to my ears.
Well, in any case, it gave us the ability to use and program apps like in a traditional operating system which runs on your smartphone or on your laptop. Unlike in proprietary environment, we use software modules, or so-called container, and that's a big advantage for the usability and the security of the whole system.
And it creates completely new possibilities for what you can do with such a control platform.
Yes, of course. It creates totally new possibilities, which we do not even know yet.
Okay, but why do we need the Controlix data layer then?
Well, the apps have to communicate with each other, or sometimes they have to share their data, and therefore we created the Controlix data layer.
Okay. This means the Controlix data layer connects all the individual apps which can normally not communicate with each other so easily.
Yes, the Controlix data layer is a place where the apps can communicate or share their data.
Okay. But what makes the Controlix data layer so unique?
Good question. I try to explain. The different application provides some data. For example, the PLC application provides some PLC variables, or the motion application provides some access data, like a simple data provider. And another app can address the data via the Controlix data layer without any coding.
Okay. So this means one app does not need to know where another app stores its information. It can simply retrieve it from the data layer.
Yes, looks like you got it.
Okay, but how does it work? How do all the apps dock onto the data layer?
For a simple access, you can use standardized interfaces like REST and OPC UA.
Johannes, I know OPC UA and REST, but here we have a real-time system. So I think we need also real-time capabilities for the Controlix data layer, right?
Yes, we need some real-time capabilities, and that was really a big challenge because sometimes the apps have to share some real-time data.
So in our Controlix data layer, any app can dynamically generate and retrieve data in real time and non-real time. This is something totally new, which nobody could provide so far.
Yes, that's really unique on the market.
So this app-based approach together in combination with our Controlix data layer sounds very exciting to me. In fact, we can't be sure what kind of software will be finally running within the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years on our system. That is really interesting for me.
Yes, that's the reason to design an open system, which is future-proof even for upcoming complex requirements. That was important for us.
I think this is a really good thing because it provides maximum flexibility to our customers.
Yes, that was our goal.
Now let's talk a little bit about performance. What are we talking about?
Yeah, we can handle about 8 million accesses per second. And before I forget to say, the data in the Controlix data layer are not only for the machine readable, but they are also human readable. And all you have to do is open your web browser and go to the data layer. Maybe it's better I show this one.
Yes, please.
So I have a little application with me, and with this application I can show you how the Controlix data layer works and how it looks like.
Then let's get started.
Yes, of course. Well, I've created a Controlix Core Virtual, but you introduced it in the last episode, right?
Correct.
Yes, and with the Controlix Core Virtual I'm able to test the whole machine without switching it on or even crash a real machine.
Or you can use it to demonstrate functions like you're probably going to do right now.
Again, you're right. Here I can open the landing page, and in the landing page I go to the Controlix data layer overview, and here you see all the data I created dynamically here, easy readable in plain text.
In plain text?
Yes, the advantage is that you have all your data you need here in a central place. You don't have to search from your data in the different snippets of your code. You have it here in a clear overview.
Okay, so this means the developer can take the data right there from the list and program his own app?
Yes, you're right. And the best thing is, this tree is created dynamically. If you register a new app, the data will show it immediately in this tree.
Okay, this means every app that gets installed automatically extends the tree with the data it provides.
True story, I will show it. Let's take a look at the motion node. This is actually empty, because no axes were configured. Let's configure one axis. So here, simply I configure one axis called axis one. So, and now the axis is available in the whole system, and we see under the motion node, here is one axis configured.
Okay.
This works similar to the PLC application. Here we see no application is downloaded. Let's do this.
Ah, here's your sophisticated PLC program.
Yeah, I will explain after I download it. So now the PLC application is downloaded. Here it's a simple application. That's all I know coding PLC. Here it's a simple start variable. If I switch the start variable to true, it will start counting. Very simple, start equals true means start counting.
That's how I started to learn programming too.
Yeah, okay. So now let's take a look at the PLC node again, and we see the application is downloaded.
So with the Controlix data layer, you can change the system data, add variables, delete variables, and so on. This means the data layer is not a static list, but you can edit during the runtime of the machine.
Yes. I can change the variables here in this data layer tree.
So the data layer is a data management and access tool.
Very precisely. I might repeat myself, but that's not all. I talked about the REST interface before, and with the REST interface, I'm able to access all the variables in the data layer tree, and I can use every REST client. For example, I use an YARC client.
YARC, that's a funny abbreviation. Yet another REST client.
As I said before, I can browse all the data. So here, for example, you see the specific URL. I'm browsing the root node of the data layer. Here you see the response.
For this, you need also authorization?
Yes, I took an authorization token before and add it to my request header, and now I'm able to access all the data. I can create one more access, for example.
Simply by inserting a REST command?
Yes, finally you got it. I just sent this REST request.
Okay. So this means you can make modifications to the Motion app remotely via the REST API, or can configure your platform by HTTP requests.
Exactly, you're right.
This is really impressive. But with such an open system, which you can even control remotely via REST API, what about security?
Good question. We developed the ControlX data layer completely new, and so we comply to the highest security requirements.
That's what I've expected. We will learn more about security in one of the upcoming episodes. We have Alexander with me, and he's our super expert who knows everything about security related to our ControlX automation platform.
Yes, my dear friend and colleague can say much more about security. One other important information is that the ControlX data layer does not know the data, it knows only where to find some.
That fits perfectly to one of my favorite slogans. You don't need to know everything, you just need to know where to find the right information.
The data layer knows it all. It's just, like the name said, a layer above the operating system. And for example, graduates can adapt the CLI interfaces and program against it in every programming language.
Exactly. We believe that the trend will go in this direction and must go. Our system can pick up young people, especially from the so-called Generation Z, from where they are. It provides them with tools and interfaces where they can start right away, and they can do so much more with it compared to a proprietary system. Yes, it's certainly impressive how you solved the data communication problem. During the development, what was the most difficult task and how did you solve it?
Oh, of course. There were many major challenges. I think one of them was real-time and non-real-time capability. But all in all, we can say the hardest thing was to make it easy.
Cool, Johannes. We've learned now what the ControlX data layer is all about. We've seen how it works as a data backbone for all the apps on our system. You've shown us an example how to process data virtually from anywhere, even remotely through a REST API. So this is very exciting. Thank you so much for giving us an insight to the ControlX data layer. And I'm really curious to see what our customers are able to do with that.
Thanks for the invitation, Christian. I had a lot of fun explaining you our neural system called ControlX data layer, which runs on this little baby. I'm looking forward to the next episode 5, I guess.
Yes.
And there you can ask me everything you want to know about our software development kit.
I will. That's it for this episode. I hope we could answer all of your questions, and I'm looking forward to your comments, further questions, and of course, your interest into our new product platform. In the next episode, we will deal with the topic of remote control and remote maintenance with the help of our ControlX device portal. The episode will be available from November 5th on, so click on the subscribe button and activate the messages with the bell so you won't miss any episode. Catch you on the next one to be 2 steps ahead. We'll be right back.